evening and a very warm welcome to those of you gathered here in the choir and those of you who join us online as we are here for the office of Choral Evensong at Chester Cathedral. You can follow the order through on the leaflets that you have. We proceed largely unannounced. If you wish to follow the Psalms this evening, they are to be found in the Book of Common Prayer that are present in the stalls. It's the Psalms appointed for today, Psalms 82 through to 85. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, let us pray with one heart and mind. As our evening prayer rises before you, O God, so may your mercy come down upon us to cleanse our hearts and set us free to sing your praise, now and forever. Amen. The first reading is written in the sixth chapter of the writings of the prophet Zechariah, beginning to read at the ninth verse. It is headed, "The Coronation of the Branch." The word of the Lord came to me. "Collect silver and gold from the exiles, from Heldai, Tobijah, and Jediah, who have arrived from Babylon, and go the same day to the house of Josiah, son of Zephaniah. Take the silver and gold to make a crown, and set it on the head of the high priest Joshua, son of Jehozadak. Say to him, 'Thus says the Lord of hosts, here is a man whose name is Branch. For he shall branch out in his place, and he shall build the temple of the Lord. It is he that shall build the temple of the Lord. He shall bear royal honor, and shall sit and rule on his throne. There shall be a priest by his throne, with peaceful understanding between the two of them. And the crown shall be in the care of Heldai, Tobijah, Jediah, and Josiah, son of Zephaniah, as a memorial in the temple of the Lord. Those who are far off shall come and help to build the temple of the Lord, and you shall know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. This will happen if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God.'" Here ends the first reading.
Thank you.
The second reading is written in the first letter of Peter, chapter 2, beginning to read at the fourth verse. Come to him, a living stone, though rejected by mortals, yet chosen and precious in God's sight. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it stands in Scripture, see, I am laying in Zion a stone, a cornerstone chosen and precious, and whoever believes in him will not be put to shame. To you then who believe, he is precious. But for those who do not believe, the stone that the builders rejected has become the very head of the corner, and a stone that makes them stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the word, as they were destined to do. But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. Here ends the second reading. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God, Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The anthem this evening, Thy Word is a Lantern Unto My Feet, is a meditation on faithful words beginning with the Hebrew letter Nun, verses from Psalm 119, music by Henry Purcell.
Thank you.
power of the Spirit and in union with Christ Jesus, let us now make our intercessions before God, our Heavenly Father. I bid you to pray in these moments now and in the litany that follows, to pray firstly as our diaries bid us, for God's church, in the worldwide communion, for Archbishop Joseph Akinfenwa in Ebdon, Nigeria, for Bishop Segun Okabajedo in Ebdon North, and Bishop Adkintunde Papula in Ebdon South. Pray too in this diocese for people of the parish of St. Hilary Wallasey, those who minister there, Alan Ward and Richard Avery, lay ministers John Tomkins, Valerie Sparks, Catherine Godfrey. Praying for their ministry to youth and children following changes to the Fusion Project. Asking God for vision, faith and imagination as they reach out to local homes and schools with the gospel of Jesus. In this cathedral community, we are bidden to pray for the congregational meeting that follows Evensong today. And in the wider community, for all who are struggling with the winter blues in the new year, those feeling hopeless, finding it hard to pay off credit card bills, and those with long-term illness. Especially we're asked to remember Alison Eastwood and Charles Hamilton Russell, and to remember with thanks the recently departed Hugh Moore, Paul Barrow and Bernard Moss. Alongside the biddings of our diaries, we pray for the governments of the world in the times in which we live, for those seeking peace amidst the inflammation of the Middle East and Iran, for those caught up in the politics of the United States of America, and for our own new government recasting relationships with neighboring states. For these and the burdens and cares that rest on our own hearts, we pray. In the litany that follows, there is a brief response to each prayer intention. Father of all, the response, hear our prayer. Sovereign Lord, your Son has revealed you as our Heavenly Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. Father of all, hear our prayer. You have made your church a spiritual family, a household of faith. Through baptism we are reborn as brothers and sisters of Christ. Deepen our unity and fellowship in him. Father of all, hear our prayer. You sent your Son to give his life as a ransom for the whole human family. Give justice, peace, and racial harmony to the world he died to save. Father of all, hear our prayer. You gave your Son a share in the life of a family in Nazareth. Help us to value our families, to be thankful for them, and to live sensitively within them. Father of all, hear our prayer. Your Son drew around him a company of friends. Bring love and joy to all who are alone. Help us to find in the brothers and sisters of Christ a loving family. Father of all, hear our prayer. You are the God of the dead as well as of the living. In confidence we remember those of the household of faith who have gone before us. Bring us with them to the joy of your home in heaven. Father of all, hear our prayer. conclude by praying for one another as we say, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.